Hi viewer, I welcome you to Erim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 3, lesson number 16. The topic is Action of Rivers. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Lesson goes. Action of rivers. That is the river erosion. That is what you are supposed to look at. Now, action of the rivers, when it comes to the development of the river profile, it acts in a number of ways. It can erode, so there is the erosion, there is the transportation, there is the deposition. Action of the rivers by erosion. That is what we want to look at. This involves the wearing away of the earth's surface through the action of naturally flowing water or rivers. So that natural flowing of the rivers and it is eroding, it is wearing away the materials with it from the surface. It is the one that we are referring to it as erosion. It occurs through the processes of hydraulic action, attrition, corrosion, and solution. We are going to look at them a short while. Let us look at these processes. Hydraulic action. It is the force of moving water and the ending effect sweep away loose materials in the river channel. Water is forced into the cracks on the river banks. What happens when the water is forced into the cracks? When the water is out against the river banks, air in the cracks is compressed. So you get the air is compressed, creating pressure, which widens the crack. As the water retreats, pressure in the cracks is suddenly released. The compression and widening of the cracks retreat repeatedly will shatter the rock, which are then carried away by the retreating water. So that repeated shattering of the rock in the crack, it finally, or when now the water starts retreating, it carries up materials with it. And that is what you are saying hydraulic action is. You can be able to see the water itself, it is the one that is used as an erosive tool when it comes to the hydraulic action. The next one, it is the attrition. We have the borders being transported downstream are in constant corrosion with each other, thereby reducing them into smaller particles. So that corrosion, you happen to get the borders will collide with one another as they are eating one another, colliding with one another. There is the smoothening that will take place, rounding of the pebbles. This one means that that process reduces the sizes. And that is what we say it is the attrition. The third one, it is the corrosion or the abrasion. The river uses its rod as erosive tool. The load is out by the river against the river bank or bed. It chips off the river bank and the bed. So in this case now, corrosion or abrasion. The rod here, it is the one that is used as an erosive tool. It is the one that is eroding the riverbeds. It is the one that is eroding the riverbeds. Then the next one, it is the solution. Running river made itself minerals from the rocks in which they are flowing. The material is carried down the river channel in solution when it dissolves in the water. So it is carried down in the river in solution state. So those are the four processes in which now a river erupts. Let us look at the factors that influence the rate of river erosion. One of the factors, it is volume of the stream or river. The larger the volume, the greater the force of moving water, and the greater the erosion. So the more the river volume, the more it has the erosion capacity. Number two, it is the nature and amount of the rot. We have large and hard object cause more erosion compared to the smaller and finer object. You can be able to see the nature of the material, how it is used, the corrosion, abrasion, how it is applied here. The third one, it is the river gradient and velocity. Steep slopes experience higher velocity of water due to the greater influence of gravitation force. The rivers flow very fast and exhibit higher rates of erosion. Then the next one, it is the nature of the river bedrock. The river bed bends with less resistance rocks are easily eroded, especially if the rocks are well jointed or soluble in water. So those are the factors that will influence the rate of erosion. Then we look at the different types of erosion. We have three of them. The first one, it is the end-wand erosion. Now, when we talk about the end-wand erosion, it involves the river extending its length by cutting back upstream above its original source. It may be caused by the spring sapping, rain wash, gully, or even the soil creep. And remember this one we have said, it is when it is retreating backward, upstream. It starts cutting the upstream from the source, going backwards. Number two, it is the vertical erosion. When we talk about the vertical erosion, it occurs in the riverbed through abrasion and solution process. It leads to the deepening of river channel. And the other one, it is the lateral erosion. It occurs on the sides, that is the riverbed of the channel. So it erodes the riverbed when it comes to the lateral erosion. Let us see. As you can be able to see, the vertical one, it is the vertical erosion. Lateral one, it is the one that is eroding the riverbeds. Activity, state four ways in which the river erodes, and then state four factors that influence the river erosion. For more information, visit the KRB 2003. Secondary Geography Student Book 3, third edition. And also, you can get us, if I tell you have more, you get more, you want to get more information, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us in the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. And also, you can Twitter us. Otherwise, stay tuned to EDM TV.